Hello everyone, welcome to StudyIQ. In this video of StudyIQ, I will bring to you the second part of second week October current affair. I have already uploaded the first part of second week in which I have covered more than 100 current affairs, and in this video I will cover around 88 current affairs. So this is part 2 of week 2. Please note, today is our last day of our sale, Diwali sale. So if you want to avail SSC, BankView, UPSC, any course, today there is flat 35% discount, and dial this number, one of the three numbers given here, or dial or go to studyiq.com. FIFA has recently suspended which country's football federation? I'm talking about FIFA. Now, FIFA's president is Gianni Infantino, and FIFA's headquarter is in Zurich. Now, remember that FIFA's headquarter is in Zurich. Zurich is in Switzerland, and in Switzerland, we also have the headquarter at Lausanne of International Olympic Committee. The head of International Olympic Committee is Thomas Bach, and Ethics Commission chairman, they have made Ban Ki-moon. Ban Ki-moon is the chairman of International Olympic Committee's Ethics Commission, but overall chairman is Thomas Bach. And the country that is suspended is Pakistan. Pakistan's Pradhan Mantri, PM, is Shahid Khakkan Abbasi. Capital is Islamabad. How many medals did India win to top the medal tally? That is, India has won the maximum medals in the Track Asia Cup that was held in New Delhi. Second position was China. India has won 21 medals. Now you should know the breakup also: gold, silver and bronze. Gold is 7, 9 is silver and 5 bronze. And remember the name of two players, they both are cyclists. Their sport is cycling, and they have qualified for the Cycling World Cup. Now their names are Deborah Herold, and second is Alina Reggie. Alina Reggie and Deborah Herold, both of them, they have qualified for the Cycling World Cup also. 44th edition of Indian Handicraft and Gifts Fair, which is the world's largest B2B, business to business handicraft and gift fair, it was recently held where? It was held at Greater Noida in Uttar Pradesh. And she is our textile minister, Smriti Rani. She is also the information broadcasting minister. And she is a Rajya Sabha MP from Gujarat. Now remember that earlier this year in 2017, we had in Gandhinagar a mega textile fair also. Kwan O-yoon, he has resigned from his position of the CEO, Chief Executive Officer of which company? He has resigned from his position of CEO of Samsung Electronics. This was after a corruption scandal. And Samsung is a company from South Korea. So is LG and so is Hyundai. Hyundai is also the sponsor, one of the sponsor of FIFA Under 17 World Cup that we have in India. Hyundai. Also Adidas. It is also a sponsor of FIFA Under 17 World Cup. As per the CSO, Central Statistics Office, India's Index of Industrial Production, IIP, reached in August a 9-month high of what percent? It reached a high of 4.3% IIP, and retail inflation was unchanged at 3.28%. Which state in India has announced a new garment and apparel policy for 2017? And 4,000 rupees they will provide to every woman weaver, and 3,200 per month they will give to every man weaver. This is a new policy of Gujarat. Gujarat has run of Kutch Marine National Park. It also has Gir National Park, which is the only national park in India which has lions. And now in Palpur Kuno, it is a wildlife sanctuary in Madhya Pradesh, lions are being shifted from Gir to Palpur Kuno in Madhya Pradesh. Gujarat will have elections very soon. Chief Minister is Vijay Rupani. Which Indian cricketer has announced his retirement from competitive cricket? Now, Board of Control for Cricket in India CEO is Rahul Johri. Rahul Johri is the BCCI CEO, and the cricketer is Ashish Nehra, fast bowler, left arm. Who has been honored with Vayo Shrestha Samman, which is a national award for senior citizens by President Ramnath Kovind, who is the 14th President of India. His name is Mr. Gurbakh Singh Sandhu, and he is the boxing coach of Indian team. He is the boxing coach. Now remember one more award, very very important. Lal Bahadur Shastri Award. It is a national award for excellence in public administration. It has been given to Dr. Bindeshwar Pathak. Dr. Bindeshwar Pathak has recently written a book called Making of a Legend, Narendra Damodar Das Modi. And he is also the founder of Sulabh International. Which Indian footballer scored India's first ever goal in a FIFA competition in a match against Colombia in FIFA Under 17 World Cup? His name is Jackson Thaunao Jam. And he is from Manipur. And Colombia's capital is Bogota. It is a country in South America. Now remember, important personalities from Manipur. You should know Irom Sharmila. And you should know Mary Kom, who has been appointed as the business head of MobiQuick Payment Gateway. They have appointed Rukaiya Rangwala. And MobiQuick was founded by Bipin Preet Singh, who is also the CEO of the company. This is very important. Bipin Preet Singh and Upasana Taku. They are the founders, but Bipin Preet Singh is the CEO. Similarly, for Paytm, CEO is Vijay Shekhar Sharma. That is also the main competitor of MobiQuick these days. They also ask in exam the CEO of Ola and Uber. So Uber is Dara Khosrow Shahi and Ola is Bhavish Agarwal. Finance Minister Arun Jaitley recently attended the G20 Finance Ministers and Central Bank Governors meeting at which place? All the finance ministers of G20 countries recently they met at Washington DC. India is also a member of G20 and G20 summit this year was in Hamburg in Germany. And next year in 2018, it will be in Argentina. The capital of Argentina is Buenos Aires. World's largest combustion research center, which is called National Center for Combustion Research and Development, was recently inaugurated at which IIT? It was inaugurated at IIT Madras in Chennai in Tamil Nadu. Amazon Web Services, it has tied up with which company to launch an open source and deep learning interface which is called Gluon. Gluon is a product of Amazon and Microsoft together. So two giants have come together and Microsoft, Satya Nadella is the CEO, is the chairman. And Amazon, Jeff Bezos is the CEO. Our central government has approved signing of a MOC with which country on establishing a liquid, flexible and global LNG market, liquefied natural gas market. This country is also the largest importer of LNG. It is Japan. And India is the fourth largest importer of LNG. Our Minister for Oil and Gas is Dharmender Pradhan. And Dharmender Pradhan is also the Minister for Skill Development. World Standards Day was observed on which day? It was observed on October the 14th. But the more important thing is that, what was the theme? The theme was Standards Make Cities Smarter. Standards make cities smarter. Now let me tell you something which is extremely important. There are two countries, one is France and one is Germany. Germany is making KBC smart city in India. K stands for Kochi, B stands for Bhubaneswar and C stands for Coimbatore. Kochi is in Kerala, Coimbatore is in Tamil Nadu, Bhubaneswar is the capital of Odisha. So Germany is making three smart cities in India, Kochi, Bhubaneswar and Coimbatore. France is making PNCH. Okay. So N stands for Nagpur, P stands for Puducherry and CH stands for Chandigarh. Chandigarh, Nagpur and Puducherry are being made smart cities by France, whereas Kochi, Bhubaneswara and Coimbatore are being made the smart cities by Germany. Germany's Prime Minister is Frank-Walter Steinmeier, Germany's President. But please remember, President is only a ceremonial position in Germany. Real power is in the Chancellor's hand, executive power. And Angela Merkel is the Chancellor. She has become the Chancellor for the fourth time. Which of the following Indian naval ships, they are visiting Japan at a place called Sasebo to take part in the passage exercise, which is called PASEX. Two Indian ships are there, INS Satpura and INS Kadmat. So the answer is 3 and 4. INS Satpura and Kadmat are taking part in exercise called PASEX. And Japan and China, they have, controversial relationship over East China Sea. And China also has troubled relationship with at least 8 countries from South China Sea. Also, we do a exercise with China also, which is called Hand in Hand. The annual seminar on India and Southeast Asia, which is Maritime Trade Expedition and Civilizational Linkages, it recently began at which place? It was conducted in Kerala at the Indian Naval Academy. And our Navy Chief is Sunil Lamba. International Association of Marine Aids to Navigation and Lighthouse Authority, which is called IALA. It is headquartered in France at a place called Saint-Germain, has been approved by Cabinet for changing its status from an NGO to what? It will now not be called non-government organization, it will be called inter-government organization. So the answer is IGO, intergovernmental organization. And you know, it is headquartered in France. Now France's capital is Paris, and Paris is the headquarter of OECD, Organization for Economic Cooperation and Development, and UNESCO, who has been awarded the K. Shivaram Karant Huttura Prasasti. This basically is an award which is instituted in the name of Gyanpith winner. His name was K. Shivaram Karant. His name is Prakash Raj. He was in news recently because he said, "I am not a fool," and he criticized Narendra Modi. Which of the following departments has launched the Sampoorna Bima Gram Yojana? Under the Sampoorna Bima Gram Yojana, you know, at least one village in every revenue district will be identified in each of the revenue district, and where the effort will be made to cover all the households with a minimum of one rural PLI policy, personal life insurance policy. That is called Sampoorna Bima Gram Yojana. And our Minister for Communication is Manoj Sinha, and Minister for Rural Development is Narendra Singh Tomar. So which of the following department has launched it? It is the Department of Post, and Department of Post also have a India Post Payment Bank. Who has been appointed as the Managing Director of Facebook India? He will replace Umang Bedi, who recently stepped down because of personal reasons. His name is Sandeep Bhushan. And Mark Zuckerberg is the CEO of Facebook, and Sheryl Sandberg is the COO of Facebook. Government has recently announced that transportation of the natural gas through pipeline will attract a GST without input tax credit of how much percent? And if I ask with input tax credit, then how much percent? So without input tax credit, it is 5%, and with input tax credit, it is 12%. So mark the answer accordingly. Securities and Exchange Board of India, its chairman is Ajay Tyagi, and it is headquartered in Mumbai. It is the capital market regulator. It has directed the stock exchanges of India like Bombay Stock Exchange and National Stock Exchange to impose a fine of how much amount per day on the companies that do not follow the minimum public shareholding rules and regulation. So SEBI has asked these stock exchanges to put a fine of 5,000 rupees per day on these companies. And remember that Bombay Stock Exchange recently had their new chairman. His name is Dhirendra Swaroop. Dhirendra Swaroop is the new chairman of Bombay Stock Exchange, and Ashish Chauhan is the new CEO of Bombay Stock Exchange. India recently began an exercise called Mitra Shakti at Aund military station in Pune with which country? So Mitra Shakti is an annual exercise which we do with Sri Lanka, and this time we are doing it for counter terrorist operations. Also, there is the border between India and Sri Lanka is called Palk Strait. It is the only water border or maritime border which we have directly. Otherwise, with all the other countries, we have a land border. And Sri Lanka's president is Maithripala Sirisena. Prime Minister is Ranil Wickremesinghe. We are building a port in Sri Lanka called Trincomalee. China is building a port called Hampantota. And Sri Lanka's capital is Sri Jayawardenepuri, Kotte. India has secured a direct qualification in the 2019 AFC ASEAN Cup. I am talking about football. So this, they have done it for the first time in the last 33 years after defeating which team? They defeated Macau. And also remember that 2019 AFC Asian Cup football will take place in United Arab Emirates. How much amount has Inland Waterways Authority of India raised through Government of India's fully serviced bonds recently? They have raised 660 crores. Which city is going to host an international puppet festival for the very first time? Puppet festival. It will be organized by Kolkata. Now, Kolkata is the capital of West Bengal, and it is called City of Joy. Chief Minister is Mamata Banerjee of the Trinamool Congress Party, and West Bengal has Neora Valley National Park. It also has Baksa National Park and Gorumara National Park. As per the World Payment Report of 2017 by Capgemini and BNP Paribas, the digital payments in the world during 2016 to 2020, they will grow at a compound annual growth rate of what percent? And India may be in global top 10 market when it comes to digital payments increase. So this will grow at 26.2% annually. International Monetary Fund, they have decreased India's GDP growth forecast from 7.2% to what? Please remember, International Monetary Fund is headquartered in Washington, D.C., which also has the headquarter of NASA and of World Bank. And International Monetary Fund chief is Christine Lagarde. Christine Lagarde, and she's a very important person. She's the Director General of IMF, and she is from France. So now they are saying we will grow at only 6.7%. Who has become the first female referee to officiate in a match at the FIFA Under 17 World Cup? And this match was played at Salt Lake Stadium in Kolkata. Her name is Esther Stobley, and she is from Switzerland. Which of the following Palestinian political parties, they have reached a deal over political reconciliation? So it's a sort of compromise reached between Fatah and Hamas. So the answer is 1 and 4. And Palestine's capital is East Jerusalem. And Israel's capital is Jerusalem. Israel's currency is shekel. Israel's prime minister is Benjamin Netanyahu. Which of the following announced the launch of a mobile app which is called Trade Transaction Tracker? And now on real-time basis, the customers will be able to track the status of their trade transactions. This has been launched by HSBC, Hong Kong and Shanghai Banking Corporation, and this is headquartered in London. Which bank has recently announced the launch of Smart-up Zones in the branches across India? And this is basically an exclusive area inside the branch which is dedicated to startups. It is called Smart-up Zone. It has been designed by HDFC Bank. HDFC Bank Managing Director is Aditya Puri. It is a domestic systemically important bank. There are only three banks in India which have this status: HDFC Bank, ICICI Bank and State Bank of India. MasterCard has announced the launch of its India Innovation Center at which place? This is only their second innovation center. One is in Singapore and this one is in India. So this will be in Maharashtra. Maharashtra has Gugamal National Park, Chandoli National Park, Taloba National Park, Fansad Wildlife Sanctuary, Sanjay Gandhi National Park. And remember again, MasterCard is an American company. And one more thing, Ajay Banga is the CEO of MasterCard and he is an Indian. Now, can I ask you a very difficult question? Shantanu Narayan is a CEO of a big company and he is an Indian. Which company I am talking about? Our central government has approved a memorandum of understanding with which country for cooperation in the field of vocational education and training, VET. So which country is this? It is Belarus. The capital is Minsk. We have signed a memorandum of understanding with Belarus. The capital is Minsk. Who has been chosen for the Matrubhumi Literary Award for 2016? He is a Malayalam writer. He writes in Malayalam, which is the state language of Kerala. His name is M.K. Sanu. Who will head the national committee? So basically, 150th birth anniversary of Mahatma Gandhiji will be celebrated from October 2nd, 2019 to October 2nd, 2020. So for that, there is a national committee which will implement this commemoration. Who is the head of this committee? His name is, of course, Narendra Modi. He is the Prime Minister of India and he will head this committee. Who has been appointed as the new CEO of HSBC? He will take over from Stuart Gulliver and his name is John Flint. Arjen Robben, he is retired from international football. He plays for which football club? He plays for FC Bayern Munich, or also called FC Bayern Munich, is a German club. But remember, he plays for Netherlands country. His country in Netherlands or Holland, but his club is a German club called FC Bayern Munich. Central government has imposed an anti-dumping duty on import of certain steel wire rods for 5 years from which place? Because to protect our domestic market, Directorate General of Anti-Dumping and Allied Duty, which is called DGAD, has put this on steel from China. Now my second question for you today: who is the steel minister of India? Write down in comments. Union Cabinet has given its approval for signing of a memorandum of understanding with which country in the cooperation in the field of water resources? We are already cooperating with Israel for water resources because it is providing us drip irrigation specialization in agriculture. Now water resources, we are cooperating with Morocco. Capital is Rabat. It is mostly a Saharan country, North African country, desert country, and that is why it knows how to manage its water resources. Our minister for water resources is Nitin Gadkari. He is also the minister for Ganga rejuvenation, river development and transport minister also. With which country has Indian Railways signed a joint declaration of intent? This country will help the Indian rails achieve a speed of 200 km per hour. This is of course Germany. National Highway Authority of India, NHAI, it has been assigned by Moody's Investor Service what rating? This rating is BAA3, which means there is a very high chance that the NHAI will receive support from the government if it is in a bad situation or distressed situation. NHAI builds roads in India, and NHAI is headquartered in New Delhi, and its chairman is Deepak Kumar. US Liberian Clinical Research Partnership has reported successful clinical trials of two experimental vaccines against which of the following disease? These two vaccines are for Ebola virus, and again it was done in Liberia. Satish Chandra passed away. He was a noted what? So he wrote the book NCERT's Medieval History. He was also one of the chairmen of ex-chairman of University Grants Commission UGC. He was a very renowned historian. Which of the following has launched a mobile health app which is called MedWatch? MedWatch is an app which is launched by the Indian Air Force, and it is developed by Directorate of Information Technology, also called DIT. And BS Dhanua, Birendra Singh Dhanua, is the Air Chief Marshal. Central government has approved setting up of two sewage treatment plant at which of the following location in the public-private partnership model for a combined cost of 324 crore rupees under the Namami Gange program, which is regarding the cleaning of Ganga. It is carried out by National Mission for Clean Ganga, NMCG. Our minister for the same is Nitin Gadkari, who is a Lok Sabha MP from Nagpur. So two sewage treatment plant will be at Haridwar and Varanasi. Now Haridwar is in Uttarakhand and Varanasi is in Uttar Pradesh. So the answer is 1 and 2. As per the Reserve Bank of India, gross non-performing assets ratio for non-banking financial company, it has increased to how much percent at the end of March 2017? Now they have reached 74,000 crore rupees. More than that, 74,230 crore rupees. It is 5%. And remember that the non-performing asset ratio of banks has increased. I'm not talking about non-banking financial company. I'm talking about banks now. It is 10.21%. And the total non-banking total banking non-performing assets have reached 12 lakh crore rupees now. Tata Teleservices has announced to merge its consumer mobile business operation with which company? So the telecom mergers are taking place a lot now, and it is merging with Bharti Airtel. Who is the Bharti Airtel CEO? His name is Gopal Vittal, and the chairman is Mr. Sunil Mittal. Gopal Vittal is the CEO, and chairman and founder is Sunil Bharti Mittal. Now remember, Tata chairman is N. Chandrasekaran. He is the overall chairman of Tata Group. Which state in India has recently approved reservation for the persons with disabilities in all the government jobs and educational institution? This state is Bihar. It has Valmiki National Park. Only one national park is there, Valmiki National Park. And chief minister, who is also the chief minister for sixth time, is Nitish Kumar. His party name is JDU. From 9th to 14th of October 2017, the government of India celebrated which scheme? Government of India celebrated Beti Bachao Beti Padhao scheme. Save the girl child. Beti Bachao Beti Padhao. The daughters of New India was the theme. The daughters of New India. Our Minister for Women and Child Development is Maneka Gandhi, who is a Lok Sabha MP from Pilibhit in Uttar Pradesh. Which company recently launched India's third biggest IPO, initial public offering, for 11,370 crore rupees? This company is General Insurance Company Reinsurance, GICRE. India has denounced signing the Nuclear Non-Proliferation Treaty as a non-nuclear weapon state. So basically, Pakistan, Israel and India, they were asked to cut down on their nuclear weapons, but India refused. Now, who was India's permanent representative to the Conference on Disarmament and Nuclear Non-Proliferation? His name is Amandeep Singh Gill, and Syed Akbaruddin is our UN permanent representative to the United Nations. Vikas Swarup is our High Commissioner to Canada. Which state government has launched a website called Mahalabharti, which is to help the people of this state, give all the information to them about the important government schemes in this state? It has been done by the government of Maharashtra. Devendra Fadnavis is the chief minister. It's a coalition government between BJP and Shiva Sena. What is Delhi's rank on the Safe Cities Index by The Economist, which has ranked 60 cities of the world? Delhi's rank is a very, very poor 43rd. So Delhi is the out of 60, Delhi is 43rd. And Mumbai in this very list is at 45th place. Mumbai is 45th. Number one city is Tokyo. That is, it is the safest city in these 60. Which company has recently launched their computer chip, which is called Pegasus? And this computer chip will be used in auto driving or self-driving vehicle. This country is Nvidia. Who has become the first cricketer from Bangladesh to be inducted in the Melbourne Cricket Marylebone Cricket Club World Cricket Committee, MCC World Cricket Committee, under the chairmanship of Mike Getting. He is the first player from Bangladesh and in the MCC. But there are other players also, like Ian Bishop is there, Kumar Dharamsena and Susie Bates. But from Bangladesh, he is first. His name is Shakib Al Hasan. International Day for Disaster Reduction was observed with the 2017 theme, Home Safe Home, Reducing Exposure, Reducing Displacement. This is called International Day for Disaster Reduction. And in India, National Disaster Response Force Chairman is Sanjay Kumar, who was the ex-DGP, Director General of Police of Himachal Pradesh. So, this day was observed on October the 13th. What is India's rank out of 119 countries in the Global Hunger Index, which was launched by the International Food Policy Research Institute? India is poor even than North Korea, Bangladesh and Iraq. But India is ahead of Pakistan. India's rank is 100. Last year we were 97. So we have slipped 3 places. European Securities and Market Authority, which is called ESMA, it has certified MCCIL, which is the clearing arm of which stock exchange, as a third country central counterparty. This they have done it for Metropolitan Stock Exchange, MSE, and its managing director and CEO is Mr. Uday Kumar. LG Electronics India, again LG is a company from South Korea. LG Electronics India has partnered with which company to launch a co-branded EMI card? Co-branded, that is both the company's logo will be there on the this card, and it will allow to buy LG products at no cost EMI option. They have tied up with Bajaj Finance. Which country has recently launched its fourth Michibiki satellite? This is their new GPS. Now if you remember, India also launched its GPS, which was called IRNSS Navic. It was also called Navic, but it failed. So Michibiki satellite is of Japan. And remember the rocket name also. The Japan rocket is called H2A and China's rocket is called Long March. Who is going to head the commission that is being constituted to recommend a new salary structure for the judges of the lower courts of India? So his name is P.V. Reddy. This will be called P.V. Reddy Commission. Which of the following has become the first Indian oil company to enter the lubricant market in Myanmar? Myanmar's president is Hatin Kayao. They were in news because of Rohingya issue. And most of the Rohingyas are in the Rakhine state in Myanmar. The capital of Myanmar is Naypyi Taw. The company in question here is HPCL, Hindustan Petroleum. And Bharat Petroleum is the 8th Maharatan company of India. Who has become the first Indian ambassador of Laureas? First Indian ambassador of Laureas is Yuvraj Singh. International Cricket Council has given its approval. Now there will be a test championship and a one-day international league. How many of the 12 test approved countries will initially be a part of the championship? Not all the 12 test playing countries are a part of this test championship. Only 9 have been selected. Which are the 3 countries that have been excluded? Zimbabwe is not playing. Zimbabwe is not allowed to play. Afghanistan and Ireland. These have test match status, but these will not play in the league. And there are 3 important people in ICC. The chairman of ICC is Shashank Manohar. He's an Indian. The president is Zahir Abbas, who was called the Donald Bradman of Asia. He was a Pakistan batsman. And one more person you should know, David Richardson. He is the CEO of International Cricket Council. Who has been appointed as the new Director General of UNESCO? Her name is Audrey Azoulay and she is from France. Now, IMF Director General or IMF Chief is also from France. Her name is Christine Lagarde. So remember both of these. And UNESCO is also headquartered in France in Paris. Reserve Bank of India has said that if you, they have put a limit on prepaid payment instrument, PPI. What is the cash loading limit per month, which has been fixed by RBI? It is 50,000 rupees for your prepaid payment instrument. Which of the following schemes, skill development scheme is backed by World Bank? It has been approved by the cabinet. Remember, there are 2 important schemes. One is called Strive and another is called Sankalp. Now, what is Strive and what is Sankalp? So Strive full form is Skill Strengthening for Industrial Value Enhancement. In other words, Strive. And it is a scheme worth 2,220 crore rupees and 50% will be funded by the World Bank, 50% will be funded by the central government. And Skill Development Minister is Dharmendra Pradhan, who is also Oil and Gas Minister. Second scheme is Sankalp. The full form of Sankalp is Skills Acquisition and Knowledge Awareness for Livelihood Promotion. In other words, Sankalp. It is a scheme worth 4,445 crore rupees and again 3,300 crore will be borne by the World Bank. World Bank president is Jim Yong Kim and CEO is Kristina Georgieva. So the answer is 3 and 4. World Bank has reduced India's GDP forecast. Earlier they were saying we will grow in this fiscal at 7.2%, but now they have reduced it to 7%. And as I said, CEO of World Bank is Kristina Georgieva, president is Jim Yong Kim. Which state government has approved a climate change adaptation policy to develop environment-friendly villages and cities in this state? This has been done by the government of Maharashtra. Gujarat government has decided to set up how many GIDC estate with an estimated investment of 15,000 crore rupees. They will set up 16 GIDC estate and they will provide job to 40,000 youth in 14 districts of Gujarat. As per a report by LinkedIn, what is India's rank in terms of global pharmaceutical and biotechnology workforce? In fact, India is one of the leaders in the world in generic drugs manufacturing. India's position is second, and more than 13% of the workforce, global workforce in pharmaceutical, is made by Indians. Now also remember, the CEO of LinkedIn, his name is Jeff Weiner. Jeff Weiner. The first meeting of Economic Advisory Council, the chairman of Economic Advisory Council is Bibek Debroy. And the meeting was held at which place? It was held in New Delhi. But remember one more important person. Principal advisor in the Economic Advisory Council is Mr. Ratan Vattal. Ratan Vattal is the principal advisor and chairman is Bibek Debroy. Which state government has announced ration card for nomadic tribes living across the state? All the nomadic tribes in this state, they will be provided ration card. This decision has been taken by the government of Haryana. Now remember, Haryana, there is Kalesar National Park and it also has Sultanpur National Park. The governor is Kaptan Singh Solanki, chief minister is Manohar Lal Khattar. Union Cabinet has approved signing of a MOU by SEBI with the Capital Market Authority, CMA, of which country? That is, SEBI is India's capital market regulator and CMA, that is Capital Market Authority, of which country? This is the capital market regulator of this country. So the country in question here is Kuwait. Kuwait, capital is Kuwait City. Remember, one more country we have signed, it is Gibraltar. We have signed with the Financial Services Commission or FSC of Gibraltar also. Who has taken over charge as Vistara CEO? Vistara CEO is Leslie Thung. Vistara is a Tata Airlines and Singapore Airlines joint initiative. Which of the following countries have announced to withdraw from UNESCO from December 2018? And you know that UNESCO is headquartered in Paris. And these countries were saying that UNESCO is against Jews. UNESCO is against Jews. So America and Israel have withdrawn. So the answer is 1 and 2. Now remember, new chief of UNESCO is Audrey Azoulay from France. 48th Conference of Governors is what recently held at which place? 48th Conference of Governor. It was held in New Delhi in Rashtrapati Bhavan. Rashtrapati Bhavan is located at Raisina Hill. Which space agency has recently launched the EchoStar 105 SES-11 satellite? And it also did a successful landing in the Atlantic. It was launched by SpaceX. CEO is Elon Musk and rocket is Falcon 9. Reserve Bank of India has asked the mobile wallet companies. Now this is interesting. If you don't do KYC, then what is the limit? The limit then is 10,000 rupees only in your mobile wallet. So you better do a KYC compliant mobile wallet. Who chaired the first meeting of International Oil and Gas Think Tank, which is formed by the government? This meeting was chaired by a person no less than the Oil and Gas Minister Dharmender Pradhan. Which of the following chief minister started 50 buses under the Sankalp Seva service? So they will connect Lucknow to 6,000 villages. This is started by Yogi Adityanath, and Uttar Pradesh has Dudhwa National Park. It also has a nuclear plant at Naroda. Which bank has announced to set up India's largest innovation center in Mumbai at a cost of 100 crore rupee? This will be set up by State Bank of India. And it will be set up at Belapur in Navi Mumbai. State Bank of India's new chairman is Rajneesh Kumar. Which bank has launched an initiative called Small Medium Enterprises Assist, SME Assist, which is to provide short-term working capital loans to MSME client. So which bank I'm talking about? Again, it is State Bank of India. So this was the part 2 of October week 2. And tomorrow I will bring to you week 3 part 1. Thanks for watching.